What up, y'all? Welcome back to another episode of Acquired Taste. I'm gonna go ahead and run right into it. Today we're watching one of my favorites, Kang Daniel movie featuring Dawn, but it's spelled D-V-W-N. I love it. Kang Daniel, aka Dane Canyon, born December 10th, 1996, is a South Korean singer, songwriter, and actor under Connect Entertainment, a label he founded in 2019. He made his solo debut in 2019. On August 3rd of 2020, he released his second mini album, Magenta, the second part of his Color series. In this album, he wanted to show what many think is the most Kang Daniel-like and bring energy to his listeners through fun, dance, and music. Movie is the fifth track on the mini album. It features Dawn, pronounced Dawn, born February 24th, 1994, a South Korean singer who debuted in 2018 and is now under KOZ, K-O-Z Entertainment, a subsidiary of HYBE Labels. Nah. Yes. Calcifer. His tattoo. The guys are sitting there. Is that the choreographer?
Cute.
His face.
Right. So strong.
Mm-hmm. The older guys are very important in the game. With a green screen, you get on one rock.
It was actually raining.
Rain that day. Yeah.
They said rain or shine.
All right, BTS, I love it. All right, no rain. We're gonna do this scene really quick. Let's go, 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 go.
Let's just add umbrellas.
I appreciate seeing the process at the end of the video. That's dope.
Yeah, that was. I loved that.
That's really
that
dope.
That was awesome.
Hope they continue to do that.
He's an artist.
Yeah. So Kang Daniel was the one with the tattoos or the other one in the yellow?
The one in the yellow.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
That's what I thought. Well, shout outs to Kang Daniel for putting this together. Dope stuff. Shout outs to Dawn for introducing yourself in a sense, at least to me. Love your look. Really do. I'm getting Jay Park vibes in the sense of what Kang Daniel's trying to build.
Leadership.
I'm getting Jay Park vibes, and that's dope. Dope to say because earlier we watched a video on Jay Park, but it seems like he's so solid in what he does. He's now trying to make sure that the bed that he's in is big enough for other people.
No, absolutely.
So yeah, that's really all I have to say about it. The video was tight. Outfits were amazing. It was great to see the BTS at the end was probably the best thing. Because you got to see that it was raining, you know what I'm saying? You got to see that how the people came in, you know what was happening in the background. Although it was brief, we definitely got to see some of it. And that was dope. And then last but not least, someone says that the Canadian singer-songwriter was the guy, was Henry Lau? That was the guy who was the driver?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, and they said most of the people in the video were Korean celebs. So yeah.
Okay. These people look familiar. We've seen them before.
So yeah, shout out to Ken Daniel, man. More things from you. I really like this vibe. I really do. Yes.
It seems all very natural to him, all very effortless. Like, I feel like because of how effortless things are for him, it seems like, you know, you can see it on him when he's doing the music videos. I would have believed, without seeing this, like if he could have done it in one shot kind of thing, like it being like a one shot, like from the house and walking to his destination. Like, I feel like he could have done it as a one shot because of how effortless he can do things, because of how natural he brings his personality into his music videos. Like, he's just so, he was meant to be a leader. He was meant to be a star.
It was just a all around good artwork piece. It was a good song. It was a good video. The concept was nice and he put in hard work. I don't really have a lot to say because it was just good.
All right, we're gonna move on to our next video of today. We have Crush.
This is such a good episode.
Got you all in check. I love it. Shout out to Busta Rhymes. Shin Hyo-seo, born May 3rd, 1992, professionally known as Crush, a South Korean R&B singer, R&B and hip-hop singer, songwriter, and producer currently under P Nation. Crush debuted back in 2014. On May 6th of 2016, while under Amoeba Culture, he released his first mini album, Interlude, where Woo-ha serves as the title track.
I did not know this is where it was gonna go.
This is when he first came out. Okay. Come on, maturity.
It got weirder over time. I love it.
And his voice matured.
Because
he's nasally.
Can we pause for a quick second?
Did she just do that shit on purpose? Bitch, that ain't cute. Clean that shit up.
Job though. Okay, shoulders.
Right.
colors. All right, how it turned out.
I heard that sound in a while. Who's that? What is that?
I love that. That sound is really dope.
Who's used this sound before?
If this was the baseline beat for a song and then they like had a Drake down and then Woods jumped on the beat, I'll be here for
it. Woods, yep.
So, Crush, I will say from bottom to top, he has been one of the most solidly weird artists that I've seen from top to bottom. No, seriously, great artist. This particular video, for me, the story was there and it was concise and it was clear, but I really didn't care for it. Like, personally, I like the colors. I like the fact that it was a big like studio session. I like the fact that they reoccurred the bed a few times. I didn't even like the forest scene from here and there. But like, yeah, like, it wasn't a bad story at all. There's nothing wrong with it. I myself, though, was more enthralled in like Crush and the colors and the scene itself rather than the story for the video, like the video itself. Even if the video itself is not creative, a creative visual storytelling like the rest of his have been, the visual is there and Crush's presence within the scene, he always does it right. I don't know what it is, but he's really good on camera. Mm-hmm. So that's it for me, Crush, keep doing it, bro. Like, once again, in the conversation of legendary K-pop artists that don't get their actual due, Crush.
I love Crush. Crush is so fun. I will say, because this was such a different version of him, I was a little like, who is this? Because it's just, I don't know him as, like, I know him as R&B, but this was very, like, Americanized R&B. Like, the music video-wise, like, I see this type of music video happening here. Mm-hmm. So that was very, like, but you're weird. Let me see weird. And I mean, it worked, because you're killing it. Like, you've grown so much, you've shown more and more of yourself, you became who you want to become, and like Malik said, I mean, even though you don't hear a lot of people talking about Crush, he needs to be talked about, because this man is an artist. Like, he's crazy talented, mm-hmm. And I'm excited to see what the future holds for you. Like, wild. You're awesome.
Yeah. Artiste.
Well, when he started... when he started singing, all I heard was like a baby.
Yay!
And I was like,
I didn't expect
that. That's why I was like, when did this come out? I knew it was his, because he sounded more nasally when he first came out, but now his voice has matured so much, so I love the growth.
Basically, Annette in the chat says, I don't know why the wah sounds like an auto-tune baby crying.
Okay, so we are here. We're here. Yeah, I wasn't paying attention to the storyline either. Yeah. I was paying attention to like the setup and what it looked like. I like the hazy fit. Feel of it, like the dreamscape feel. That was super cool, and the bed was super cool. That was a good idea to have like all the musicians there, and he's like in the middle and like he's just singing. I actually like that. This was like cute. It was really cute, and I like that I can hear the growth within your voice from what it was back then to now. More Crush, of course, and that's about it.
Heck yeah. Mm-hmm. So today, we had an episode where we watched Crush get back into the colors, you know, of his youthfulness. Mm-hmm. And also, we got to see Kang Daniel and Dawn do a really awesome theatrical performance in the rainy days of Korea. I don't know where they shot it, but in the rainy days of wherever they shot it. It's been a great episode for young, vibrant energy.
Yeah. Artists.
Young artists, young creatives. We love it. We'll see you guys next time. Thanks for coming through. Don't forget, wash those hands and see us on Patreon, YouTube, Twitch. Peace.
Bye.